So it's shredding time here. Purchase this Rexel P5 security level shredder. Got an awesome deal. M510, so it can handle up to 10 sheets of A4 paper at the same time. And of course, it does have quite a high security level, so it cross cut and also cuts in very small pieces. So 23 liters of bin, and of course can cut anything except plastic things, up to 200 grams of paper, and also glossy paper, but not laminated paper, and not credit cards or CDs, which I do not tend to use. So it's only for paper, but it is very secure, and it does plenty, also plenty fast, and like I said, can handle up to 10 pages at a time. So let's try and get into this box and see what we actually get. And of course, we will do some quick tests once we got this unboxed. But first off, we are met with the power cable. This is of course a European cable, because that's the market where I live in. And of course, some protective here on the top. Just remove that. Nothing really on the inside. This is a very simple product. You really only need a power cable and just plug it in and keep it running. But yeah, let's just get the shredder out itself. It is quite a heavy machine. Very top heavy, because of course all the engine and cutting blade and such is in the top of the machine, so it has a tendency to want to tip over when you move it out of the case. And you have to fiddle around that plastic a little bit, it is a little annoying, but anyway, now we got the bag out of the way. Let's have a closer look at the cable. It's just standard two-prong European cable, and of course, so that's the standard computer cable here. So yeah, nothing really interesting. Let's just take a quick look around the shredder itself. Rexel logo here on the top. Of course, silver and black accents. And you have this 23 liters of bin here. And within the bin, you actually find the instructions as well. Quite a thick instructions, because it is in various different languages. But yeah, of course, all those safety warnings. And you probably should read at least the safety part of this instructions. There are quite a lot of things you cannot shred with this one here. And of course, it's just a simple plastic bin, nothing really interesting, but have this little tab here that will push into a switch within the shredder, and so the shredder knows when you have actually removed the bin, and then you cannot shred anything. Of course, I'm not really sure what that little spot is for right there, but there is some security there, so when the bin is pulled from the device, you cannot actually shred anything. And let's take a little closer here, closer look at all the warnings on the shredder itself. So no credit card, no CDs, no tie, and be careful of it if you have long hair, jewelry on, and there's also various clips that you cannot actually shred with this one, only the small clips. And of course on the back here, you have a fan that does turn on when you're using the device, and I've also noticed sometimes it just keeps blowing air within this fan. It's quite loud fan, even after I've stopped shredding. And of course on-off switch and a power button there as well. On the bottom here, it's just all plastic. There's no really feet to protect the floor, which is kind of weird, I think. Would have been nice with some rubber feet or something that would not scratch the surface, but of course plastic is quite a soft material, so it should be just fine. I've had no issues, at least to this date. Had it a few days now. But let's actually connect this shredder and see how well it works. Should, like said, handle up to 10 sheets of paper, 80 grams piece of paper at a time. But if you put more than 10 pieces of paper, it should automatically stop and eject the paper. And of course, let's try that and see how well it actually works. But step one is, of course, plugging in the power here. You hear a few quick beeps, and then you see that LED on the left that almost looked like a play button. That means that you're in standby mode and you need to hit the power button. Till the button, you can see here, lights up constantly, and now you're actually ready to shred. All the other are just warning LEDs. The shredder should also be fairly quiet, at least to the manufacturer, but just let's just start with a single sheet of paper, 80 grams. And you can hear for yourself if you think this is quiet. I think it's okay, actually, from a shredder to be. Of course, shredders is a pretty loud device. Let's have a closer look at the result. And you can see here, this is what you end up with. Very small pieces of paper. And this is P5 security level. And that is 2 millimeter wide and 15 millimeters long. And you can really hear that fan in the background. not quite sure why, because I've turned it off, like, with the button on the device itself. But you really need to turn it off completely sometimes, because the fan just keeps spinning. But anyways, let's just try 10 sheets of paper, same size paper, so still 80 grams. This should be the maximum this shredder can handle at the same time. And as you can see, it cuts through it like butter. But of course, it takes a little bit longer than if it were just one sheet of paper. You can also see here, if I remove the bin when the shredder is on, it will notify me, of course, that the bin is not connected, and show that little red LED to the right. And of course, the little play LED is turned off. And you can see the last batch here of 10 paper. It's still possible to read maybe a letter or two, but one sheet of paper should be to 2,000 or be shredded to 2,000 small pieces from one piece of paper. So it is not impossible, but it is extremely hard to actually put this back together and be able to read anything from it. But let's try 15 sheets of paper and see if we actually get a warning when we try to shred it. And you can see here, immediately it will just stop shredding, and it will actually put the paper or push the paper out a little bit. Still is a little harder to get out, so you need to use a little force, but anyway, it will get out quite easily. So that's pretty much it. Stick to 10 sheets of paper or below and shred everything you want, like within the safety of this shredder here. No CDs and plastic stuff. I highly do recommend getting this product, especially if you can find it at a good deal. It is a very good shredder. I hope to see you again in a future video, but that's been it for this one. Take care.